Hey guys, Colin Smith here with a brand new tutorial for you this week. This week, I'm going to show you how to change the color of anything without having to make any selections. All right, here's a tip that I've been doing for a number of years now, and I use this all the time. It's the quickest way to change the color of any object. You don't have to make any selections. You don't have to grab the marquee tool or the quick selection or anything like that. No selections at all. So check this out, you're gonna love it. So in this example here, we've got these orange flowers here, and we're gonna make those yellow to match the other ones. Now, as you can imagine, doing this with the selection tool could be a lot of work, especially here where it's out of focus. Very, very difficult to select that. So I'm going to show you a technique that I've been using for a number of years. And what we're going to do is we're going to use a hue saturation adjustment layer. So we're going to go up here under hue saturation. So now we've grabbed the hue saturation adjustment layer. So what we're going to do is we're going to isolate it to just the oranges, because if we go in here and we change the hue, as you can see, it will change the color of the entire image. So I'm just going to hit the reset button right here. And we only want to change the color of the flowers. Now I know in beforehand that there's the reds and these are going to match some of the reds in the skin tone. So it's also going to affect that. And I've actually done this on purpose because I want to show you how to be able to really do this in the real world. I've got tons of pictures where I could just select one color and nothing else will change, but that's not real. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to grab this little tool here, a little finger tool. And now we're going to go down for an area of orange. We've got some pretty good oranges here. We've got some up there. Don't pick the highlight area. What you want to do is pick an area that's got some good color in there. So we're going to select there. And notice what it does is it creates this little area that's going to isolate the selection. So whatever we move now is only going to be the colors in this range. So let's have a look. Sliding that over, notice we can quickly and easily match the color of the yellow on these flowers with the other ones. And then honestly, a lot of the images you're going to do, this is all you need to do. But in this case, notice that we've got some of the similar colors here in the skin tones. So some of her skin tones have also shifted. You'll notice that the greens haven't moved. None of the other yellow flowers have moved. Blue in her shirt hasn't moved. Just the areas that have a similar red in here. Now you can choose to reduce the colors being selected by pulling this in here, and you could possibly clean it up a little bit. Maybe we move it over a little bit, but you can see we're really struggling because it really is in the same zone. So we could pull it in there a little bit, and you can see right there. It's matching. So what we're going to do is we're just going to let that selection happen nicely here. And we go back there. There we go. We've got that nice yellow going in there. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to hide this now. And we're going to use a layer mask just to paint back the areas that we don't want to be affected. So let's look at this before and after. You can see the only areas being affected right now are the flowers and her skin. So let's select the layer mask. Now we're going to grab a brush. So let's just grab a brush here with the brush tool and make sure the foreground's set to black, opacity up to 100%. You'll also notice this is a soft edge brush. So the hardness is all the way down. And then all we're gonna do now is just paint over the areas, make the brush a little bigger, hitting the right bracket key that I wanna keep. So I'm just painting over here. There we go, her face is now normal, her hair is normal, let's do her arm. And what I'm gonna do for these areas with the flowers, I'm just gonna go over it. I don't mind going over because this is a quick way to fix this. I'll show you. And notice here, I don't even have to worry about what's around there because these flowers are already yellow. So I don't even have to worry about that. So up here, we're going to get a little smaller. We're just going to kind of fix this a little bit. And we're just going into those areas there. And you can see that we've fixed everything except for a couple of little areas here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back with those. We're going to hit the X key. And all I'm simply going to do is just paint over these with the yellow. And notice what I'm doing. I'm just painting with white. And by painting with white, all I'm doing is just bringing back the areas on those masks. Same with down here. You want that yellow, just paint the yellow. Around there, you want the yellow. Just like that. Don't worry about the edges because not all of the colors have changed. And as you can see, it's that easy. So let's have a look now before and after. Click the link underneath to go to the written tutorial, and I'll give you a link to the image. I'm actually using an image off Adobe Stock. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new in here. By the way, I've got a ton of tips and techniques like this that I'm going to be sharing with you on a regular basis. So all you got to do is just hit that subscribe button right now, become a subscriber, and then you'll be informed when I have new tutorials coming out. Add a like, add a comment, let us know what you think. Let's get some conversation going here. Let's talk about Photoshop. Let's shoot the breeze. It's fun. Also, don't forget to check us out on other social media. Obviously, we're here on YouTube, but we're also on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at Photoshop Cafe. So until next time, I'll see you at the cafe. All right, so don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe, like.